to hurry here.
In case we have any newbies watching, a false count anywhere match means that this contest can literally end anywhere. Simple, right? Even Sack can understand those rules.
In describing this match, Corey, you said it can end anywhere, which means we could see this match conclude in the ring, the stands, the locker room. Heck, it could even end outside the streets.
And on top of that, it's worth noting that anything is legal in this match, guys. The only rule is there are no rules.
When it comes to Falls Count Anywhere matches, for my money, there are few better than the November 2016 battle between Charlotte Flair and Sasha Banks. He's in trouble.
He doesn't look too eager to get up, and I don't blame him.
Speaking of that classic Charlotte-Sasha encounter Corey mentioned, we should add that it was the first time ever that the Women's Championship changed hands in a Falls Count Anywhere match.
And guys, I will never forget the image of Charlotte tapping out to that unique bank statement in the crowd, surrounded by the WWE Universe.
Oh boy, he is rolling.
He's looking
Strickland, which means we're likely to see a little use of rivalry here tonight.
And keep in mind, Cole, the fact that there's no disqualification also means that anybody can interfere and there's nothing you can do about it.
He ain't hype!
This is what makes him one of the best in the business. And Byron, here we go a second time.
You gotta believe this one's over.
This one is over.
Gonna have to shake off the moderate damage that's been inflicted here and find a way to maintain the upper hand.
Here is your winner, the unpredictable Jared Arnold.
The referee's three count ends this one. And there's your winner, folks. Mojo Lou. Power in play. just barely got out of the way.
Guys, if there was one word to describe Bobby Lashley, it would be winning. Over the last two decades, it's all he's done.
He's looking a little weary here. You can bet this is about how he drew this one up.
Well, he can still win this thing, guys. We've all seen him come back from much worse.
Michael mentioned how Lashley has a history of winning, and there's a lot of truth to that.
Before joining WWE, he had an impressive amateur career, which led, of course, to his quick ascent in WWE.
During his break from WWE, he managed to balance winning the MMA championship and also winning titles.
I think we know what this is.
Impact. This capacity crowd starting to sense the end is near. I don't disagree.
It just doesn't seem to be his night tonight, guys.
Guys, I think it needs to be said that yes, while we all are enjoying watching this match, you cannot deny the real dangers these superstars are presented with here tonight.
Just can't get over the physicality of this match. This has been brutal. Perhaps thinking about what to do next here.
Well, better not think too long, though.
I have to agree with what Byron was saying about the change. The truth is that superstars change forever after competing in this demonic structure.
For once, I agree with both of them.
The fact of the matter is that tonight will likely be the most demanding night of these superstars' careers. Guys, we oftentimes talk about the dangers of competing inside Hell in a Cell. But let's not forget these competitors aren't the only ones in there. It could be just as dangerous for the official as well.
We've seen... What a punch.
That's how you stop your opponent.
That's what he was looking for, Michael.
I agree with Michael's point on the dangers of this match. I mean, the environment is so brutal for all involved. Just go back to look at referee Tim White after he officiated one of those matches.
Yeah, he was never the same after that. In fact, White said Hell in a Cell ruined his life. We may be looking at a powerbomb here.
That's exactly what it looks like to me, Cole.
Into the powerbomb position now.
And that's not necessarily where you want to be if you start the match. My boy, he is worried.
Guys, we all know the storied history of Hell in a Cell, but we'd be remiss if we didn't at least mention that the first time anybody laid eyes on this demonic structure was back in October 1997 at the Bad Blood pay-per-view.
Each of these competitors is looking for the slightest hint of weakness in the other.
Reflecting again on the first time we saw the Hell in a Cell structure, I don't think anybody at the time could have envisioned the truly merciless moments this structure would provide over the years.
And amazingly, Michael, those moments somehow become more and more barbaric with each passing match.
But for me, there is no greater thrill than being at the announce desk for a Hell in a Cell match.
Figuring out what they're going to do next.
We're coming to you live from East Rutherford, New Jersey, the site of historic WrestleMania 29. You know, Troy's point about the show evolving in recent years is absolutely right. In fact, Byron, the structure is now well over 5 tons.
And I believe that's more than twice as heavy as the original show, Michael. And believe it or not, it's increased in height by nearly 5 feet.
Here is your winner, Big Money, Jeremy.
There's no doubt about it. That's a big pinfall win right there.
I could watch them go at it each and every week. What a match.
East Rutherford hasn't sat down since the bell rang. I think they're in awe over what they just saw.